In this video, I'm going to show you how to make the dimensional model of the NorthWind data warehouse using Astah. So first we open Astah, then we go to File and New. Now we have a new project and we need to create an entity relationship diagram. So we go into Diagram and we choose ER diagram here. Once that is done, we need to figure out which entities or dimensions to add to the dimensional model. If you look into the case description for the course and you look at the main track NorthWind Traders description, we can see that Andrew is asking for a lot of different things. If you look on the bottom part of the first page, it says sales in NorthWind are commissioned by a sales representative to a customer. So here we have two business contexts. One is the sales representative and the other is the customer. In order to get a basic overview of the sales, Andrew would like you to include the sales amount as well as the number of products ordered by the customer by each sales representative. So from here we also have some facts, some measurable quantities, sales amount and number of products. Now let's follow the dimensional design approach. First, we identify the business process, that would be sales in this case. Then we identify the grain, so that is the lowest granularity or the smallest piece that composes a record in the fact table. So the smallest grain, the most small piece of information that we can have on a sale is at the item line. So remember the Bilka case. So at the item line, which for the NorthWind source database is found in the order details tables. So the order detail line, sales line item, is the lowest granularity we have for sales in NorthWind. Then we identify the dimensions, and based on the description that I just went over, at least we can see that there's something related to sales representative, so that would be the employee. Let's create that first. We click on this one in order to add an entity, and let's call that dim employee, and we use employee in singular form because that is best practice. Then we also know that we have another entity or a dimension in Kimball speak, which is dim customer. We also know that we have a product, so let's make another one, dim product. And if you look over the rest of the main track course description, case description, you will also see that at some point we need dimensions of shipper, so just make shipper here as well. And later we will also make the date dimension, but let's not do that now. So let's start out with the dim employee, and if you look at the video going over the NorthWind source database, you will know that for dim employee, we have the primary key, which is employee ID. So let's add that, employee ID, and then let's add a number of attributes, and I will use Control R for this so it becomes quicker. Let's add product name. Let's add a few other attributes that we can see from the case description that Andrew is interested in. Let's add here now supplier ID. Let's add supplier name, again, because it doesn't make sense to show the end user an ID because it doesn't make any business sense to them. Now let's add category ID. Let's add category name. Make sure to spell this correct, otherwise you're going to have trouble later. And let's add whether or not the product has been discontinued so that we can eliminate any products that are not active in NorthWind from the overview later. Then the same for the dim customer. Let's add the primary key. What's the primary key here? It's customer ID. Then a number of attributes. I'm going to use company name. Then I'm thinking ahead of myself and thinking, what is Andrew going to ask me later? Now that he has all the information that he needs, might he later come back to me and tell me, oh, I would also like this? And in order to avoid having to go back and make changes, anything that I think he might want to ask me later, I will add now. So I think that for the customized dimension table, it would be make sense that he would at some point also look into how many sales by different cities in order to look at, for example, sales coverage, that some cities are underserved. So I will put city, and along the same lines, I will also put region, and I will put postal code, and I will put country. Let's move on now to the DIMP products. What is the primary key of the DIMP products? That is product ID. So I will add product ID. Then I will add product name, and so on and so on. I don't want you to look at this, so I will just skip ahead and show you the final version here. This is my final version of the dimensional model, in which I have my foreign key constraints between my dimension tables and my fact table. I also have in my fact table the primary key, the composite primary key put in there, which is composed of the product ID and the order ID. We will change this later when we get to surrogate keys, but for now, in the staging area of our data warehouse, this is the final dimensional model for NorthWind. If we go over each of the product dimensions, you will also see that I have changed the data type for all the primary attributes and the primary key and attributes in my dimension tables. So for product ID, because it's stored in the source database as an int, I've used int here as well. For product name, I've used an int char varying of length precision 40 to store the product names. And int char varying should be used for varying when the data input is going to vary a lot. So some are going to be short and some are going to be long. And you should also use the int char instead of the char when you want to support UTF-16 character encoding, which in a data warehouse setting, if we're going to include source systems from different sources and we don't necessarily know which source systems are going to be added to the data warehouse later, we might think ahead and think to ourselves, would we ever include a source system which is not supported by a UTF character encoding? And a lot of the times the answer is going to be yes, if, for example, we need to support parts of our businesses in China or Japan, in which we, of course, have a different character set not supported in standard UTF character encoding. So I've just used the int char varying across all my string data types in order to just have the same, and then of course put the length precision in such a way that you can store the data without concatenating it. So we can see here supply ID, again an int. An int is better to use than the string data types like int char and varchar for things that you are going to be joining on, because you will get a better join performance from an int. We can see supplier name, again int char varying, category ID int char varying, and so on and so on. And of course, the relationships I've made just by dragging product ID from product table onto fact sales table, because then you establish the relationship. And later I will show you how to export this code.